like Jesus, trying to run 2 million up like peace. What's dear YouTube family, man? It's your boy Crispy Clean Cliff, man. Back at again at the hood story time, bruh. Like I say, man, I appreciate y'all, bruh. Real spill. I appreciate everybody liking, commenting, and subscribing, and give me in that motherfucking YouTube algorithm, man. I appreciate y'all, bruh. And y'all, man, y'all already know I'm just doing what I do when I do when I do, because can't nobody do it better, you heard me? Yes, sir. Just like that. And as y'all already know, this is brought to you by bitch being a real nigga. That's all that's it. That's all that's it, man. So like I say, man, shout out to everybody been subscribing. Shout out to everybody been liking and commenting and getting me in that algorithm. You hear me? Because like I tell y'all, we're going to stay down until we come up together, my nigga. I say we're going to stay down until we sit up there and come up together, my nigga. And I got faith in y'all. We gonna come up together. We all gonna come up, my nigga. You feel me? Because when you're down, it's only one way to go. And that's up. Everybody, so like I said, man, shout out to everybody. I appreciate everybody. Like I tell y'all, niggas be rapping too now. This ain't just no funny joking shit. Niggas be rapping too. It just so happened that this caught traction before the rap career. So like I always say, go to Finesse Gang Cliff YouTube page, BBD Yeller YouTube page, FTFKT YouTube page, and O-Mac the Guy YouTube page, and y'all will be doing me some justice, man. But like I say, we're going to go ahead and get into it, man, with no further ado. This the hood story time, you heard me? How me and my nigga Bradley and a whole bunch of niggas from the East End, you heard me? We sat up there and went to Dallas and Houston, you heard me? Yeah. Yeah, we brought that Little Rock to Texas. Yeah, yeah, we did. Showed the motherfucker did. And I ain't gonna lie, y'all. Hey, this one of the funnest times I had in my life, bro. This is a memory that's gonna stay with me for the rest of my life. Now, as y'all already know, some of y'all know, but if some of y'all don't, y'all know Bradley was my dog, bro. That was my brother. So as y'all, some of y'all already know, I see Lil Street be posting. This story gonna have a couple people that y'all might know, man. Y'all might know in this story, bro. But like I said, with no further ado. So, man, my 18th birthday was coming up, you heard me? Yeah. Yeah, nigga, legal. Yeah, my juve ain't a juvie no more. Yeah, I'm out there hitting grown hoes now, you heard me? Yeah. So, boom, man, my 18th birthday come around. You know Bradley a Libra. My nigga Trail a Libra. So, you already know we finna go do it up, you heard me? Yeah. So, boom. Like I say, man, my birthday was coming up, and I really didn't have plans. Bradley then was already like, bro, we finna go down to Dallas. I'm about to introduce you to my cousin Trail, because y'all nigga like to do all that dancing, and y'all just gonna hit it off. Bet. So, yeah, man, my mama had something special planned for me, but I had to tell my mama, I'm going to Texas, baby. And at that time, I was driving that 2002 Lincoln Town car, you hear me? Executive Series, the one I got off that white bitch, you hear me? Yeah. Yeah, that's the one I was driving, nigga. Slabbing, nigga. Slabbing, nigga. I wasn't driving no box Chevy, y'all was. 2002 Lincoln Town car, you hear me? Executive Series, man. Presidential shit, nigga. John F. Kennedy. So like I say, man, we done devised a plan. We all going down here to Texas because at the time, RIP Keisha Mack. At the time, Keisha Mack stayed down in Dallas. If I'm not mistaken, it was Dallas. She was in Dallas at the time, man. R.I.P. Keisha Mack. So we just going down there to do what we do when we do what we do, because can't nobody do it better than us, man, type of shit. So it was me, Bradley, Big 20, DP, Freaky Freddy, that nigga Fredo Daddy, Freaky Freddy. Like I say, Keisha already down there. God damn it, like I say, I had my nigga DP with me. Bradley, Mama Kane, Jerome, Trail them was already down there. Say, man, like I say, nigga, the Little Rock came down there, nigga. That what we did, boy. Yeah. And like I say, man, we all Libra, baby. So y'all already know it went down like Charlie Brown. So boom, mind y'all, my nigga DP, RP, my nigga Darryl Prophet. My nigga DP had never been out the state of Arkansas before. That's how you know we really in them trenches for real, you hear me? When a nigga ain't never been out of the state of Arkansas and we 18, 19 years old, that ought to let you know something, bro. We really products of our environment. But, like I say, man, we going on this motherfucking Texas road trip, bro. And like I say, I had that Lincoln Town Car Executive Series, and they had a six-disc CD change in that bitch, you heard me? Yeah. So we went over to Hollywood. Y'all know Hollywood off 65th. They sell all the fake Jordans and all the fake, you know what I mean? The nigga used to have a mixtape, boy. So we went and got that Asshole by Nature mixtape by Zero and Trey. We sat up there and got that Hurricane Chris and Boosie. Y'all remember that mixtape? Yeah. And then we had to have some of that good party music, because at the time, that hit her with that flex, hit her with that flex, hit her with that, hit her with that flex. That was a slapper. That do the Ricky Bobby stop pole for the frame, that was a slapper. Man, do the stanky leg, all that shit, boy. So like I say, man, I got the six-disc CD changer loaded up. We finna go on a road trip, you heard me? My nigga Bradley, mama Kim, she had one of them brand new Ford Flexes, so we flexing on the hood. Blood, we on the interstate banging. You know, we doing it how Lil Rock niggas do when we hit the town, my nigga. Yeah. We doing it like that when we hit the town. So boom, like as y'all already know, it's a long drive from Little Rock to Dallas. Well, first we went to Worley, then we went to Dallas, then we went to Houston, you heard me? Yeah, Little Rock and that bitch, yeah, like that. And like I say, man, the East End was like my second hood, my second home, bro. Bradley was like my brother, my nigga, so I was good in the hood when it came down to the East End, bro. Like, shout out to my niggas in the E, I love y'all. So, like I say, man, we slapping on our way to Texas, you hear me? I'm in that stinking Lincoln. Actually, Bradley was driving. Bradley in that stinking Lincoln doing the dash while we listening to Roe and Trey, some assholes by name. Y'all know Zero and Trey had the mother before he got his ass jumped. But yeah, anyway, man, we slapping, you know what I mean? High siding and gliding, man. Doing what we doing, we do what we do, man. So, yeah, man, by the time we end up in Texas, I remember they had scratch-off tickets. I'm like, damn, they got scratch-off tickets in this? This is before Arkansas had scratch-off tickets. If y'all know, you know that Little Rock didn't get scratch-off tickets until around about, like, 07, 08. So we grab a couple scratch-off tickets, you hear me? We like, yeah, we finna go have us some fun. Hey, and I'm going to make sure I drop pictures in this whole thing so I can illustrate it for y'all, because we was out there doing the dope. So, boom, like I say, we pull up to Worley first, and this one my nigga Trail at. Trail, you know I love you, bro. That's my big brother. We pull up to Worley. My nigga Trail them there, like I say, all they family there. So we over there, we intermingling, you know what I mean? Chopping it up, doing what we do, man. Trying to figure out what we finna do tonight. Like, what's the plan for tonight? Cause we out here, baby. We out here deep too. Yeah. So boom. We like, bro, what's the plan for tonight? And if y'all know Trail, boy, if y'all know my boy Montrell, y'all already know that boy is a party fool. On God, and he got it going on. So, blood, you already know he had everything lined up, right? So, boom, like I say, the plan was we finna go to Houston, but I think we ain't in Houston until the next day. So, like I say, but actually it was. So, boom, like I say, we goes to Houston. Boom. First club we hit, we in that motherfucker deep. Like I say, me, Chastity, Big 20, Bradley, Daryl Prophet, Freaky Freddy from the East End, that nigga Fredo, 11 boy Fredo daddy, Freaky Freddy. Like I say, Keisha, Trail, goddamn Jerome, OB. Man, bro, we was out there thick, man, holding it down, bro. And plus, you know, my boy, he had been living in Dallas for such a while, so he had his people too, and we just doing what we do, and we do what we do. And y'all already know, bro. If y'all don't know, you're gonna know at the end of this video, boy. That nigga Trail. Now, I used to be a... You feel me? I used to get my little gig on too now. But that was Bradley used to always tell me. He like, bro, you and Trev, y'all niggas like brothers, bro. Y'all niggas doing the same. Y'all love to knock hoes. You niggas love to sit up there and do your little dance. So boom. Like I say, when me and Trev first linked up, he wasn't lying. Bradley wasn't lying, y'all. That boy Trev was backed up. Cutting up. I'm going to put the pictures in here, man, Trail. I'm going to put them pictures in here. When I say that boy Trail had the party rooking. Boy, that bitch was rooking, man. Lil Rock and that bitch. Who you with? Who you with? Hey, who you with? Get crook. Who you with? We in this bitch deep than them. I'm going to put the pictures up for y'all, bro. We in this motherfucker deep and thick than a motherfucker. You feel me? So, yeah, as y'all already know, man, and some of y'all don't know, but y'all already know, man, niggas like to smoke sherm. Not me. ain't never smoked. I done hit the Sherm pack a couple times, but I ain't smoked Sherm, bro. So, bro, as y'all already know, man, some of y'all, I ain't capping, bro. The people who know, and I'm going to tell it how it really is. Y'all know that nigga Freddie used to be off that Wet Daddy boy, and Bradley too, but Freddie and that nigga DP, them nigga were destined to go find them some of that Wet Daddy, you heard me? Yeah, they wanted to get wet real quick. Boys were popping XOs all the way. Why y'all want to get wet anyway, bro? We in the hole. Like I say, DP ain't never been out of Arkansas, nigga, so what the fuck? But I'm so fucked up, I'm so drunk, y'all. I get outside the club, DP was like, bro, let me see your keys to your car. I'm finna go get some, me and Freddie finna go get some. I'm not even thinking, like, bro, how you gonna go get something you don't even know where the fuck you were? You ain't never even been out here, my nigga. But anyway, I threw them niggas the keys to cocks. I was in there doing my do, you heard me? Doing my do. And at the time, you heard me, all them hoes said I look like B-Hemp. Yeah. Them hoes said I look like the nigga that sung that Ricky Bobby song, man. I'm gonna put a picture up and y'all gonna see, y'all can do the comparison, Brooklyn. That what them hoes told me, you heard me? Yeah, so I had them hoes, my nigga. Yeah, them hoes like, ooh, they gonna be him. And I'm in that bitch, do the Ricky Bobby stop. Home for the brain. I was just going with it, my nigga. So, boom. Like I say, my nigga DP and Freddie done, they done took the stanky lanking and they done went who knows where. They probably went to Fourth Ward somewhere, but they found that way, daddy. Yeah. But I wasn't too much worried about it, you know what I mean? I wasn't even thinking about it. I'm inside the club. We doing what we doing. We do what we do. Can't nobody do it better just like that, like I always tell y'all, bro. So, Texas is a little different from Arkansas, especially back then. I don't know about right now. So, we was trying to get some liquor. And the venue that we was at didn't have no liquor. So, we all came with, like, beer. But at the back of the club in the parking lot, bro, it was some niggas outside that looked like they rapper DSR. Nigga looked like Big Tuck, Tom Tom, Fat Bastard. And them niggas had a Delta 88 with the trunk pop. And they had ice and bottles in there. Champagne, you heard me? Liquor and all that, you heard me? So yeah, we did what we had to do, man. We just let them know, man, Lil Rock in this bitch right now, my nigga. Yeah, it's Arkansas up in this bitch. Yeah, yeah. And we was deep. Nigga, we treated that club like it was Club 25 in the East End. If y'all ever been to the East End, the Club 25 over there by J.L. Hawkins, y'all already know what the fuck I'm talking about, bro. And I'm going to do a story time on that time, too, when we used to thug like that, bro. But like I say, man, we was down there having a marvelous time, my nigga. R.I.P. Lil Bradley. R.I.P. my nigga Dura Prophet. And R.I.P. Keisha Mack, my nigga. And y'all know Bug was a baby back then. He was no baby, but he was like a little toddler back then, man. So free my nigga Fredo, man. Lil Bug, man. Free Bug. But like I say, bro, that was one of the times to me, bro. That was one of the best times of my life, bro. Best friends. We on the motherfucking road trip. It's a nigga birthday. Man, we going to Texas. We finna go down here and get our little dance on. Cause like I said, at the time, nigga was hitting that stanky leg, you heard me? Nigga was hitting that Dougie, you heard me? Boy, it was all fun and games, like I said, my nigga. So, you know, that nigga Trail be cutting up, bro. That nigga Trail got the jumping on big old hoes. I got a picture of it. I'm going to put it up there. That nigga Trail was behind holding, breaking her all blood, hitting him with the chicken wing. I'm like, God damn, that nigga Trail, the life of the party in this motherfucker, boy. No cap. But like I say, bro, it was just one of them times. As y'all already know, man, the East End is family-oriented anyway. So both of these niggas is related anyway. So it was really just a good time, bro, around family, bro. We just had a nice little time. We out of town. We got the Six Dick CD changer. We listening to all the good songs. It wasn't no Plex. Wasn't no crazy shit going on, my nigga. Couple niggas were mean mugging us, but like I say, we thicker than Jiffy in this bitch, you hear me? Yeah. Play around and we gonna swarm your head like a group of wasps, nigga. No cap, boy. None. But like I say, man, that was a beautiful time, bro. That's one of them times that's etched in my head for the rest of my life because a nigga had just turned fresh 18. I'm with my best round, you heard me? He got his best cousin with him. My nigga Big 20 Chastity, Freddie, Armin. I can't forget my nigga Armin, bro. Shout out to my nigga Armin. Armin was in that motherfucker, him and his girlfriend and his kid. Bro, we was in that bitch thick. I ain't gonna lie to y'all, bro. We was probably way more niggas than that, but guess what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna incorporate pictures all out and through this motherfucker, bro. But, oh man. You know that, remember Wayne had a song back in the day called Stunt Like My Daddy? Boy, I always say I'm stunting like Lil Bradley because y'all know that Lil Bradley used to put that shit on. Lil Bradley, Man, look, Bradley was full of himself, boy. Y'all already know y'all couldn't tell that chocolate head nigga nothing, bro. That nigga thought he was Morris Chestnut, man. So, yeah, man, nigga used to be out there stunning like little Bradley, doing what we do, what we do, what we do, bro. It was like that, bro. Like I say, bro, it be them type of times, bro, that I cherish, bro, for the memories of my people who ain't here no more. Cause like I say, bro, Keisha gone. Bradley gone. DP gone. Lil Bug locked up. And I can only imagine Freaky Freddy going through the shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Big 20 and Chastity. Y'all know I stay tapped in. OB, I love you, Unc. Mama Kim, I love you. Brittany was out there, too. I forget to say Brittany. Brittany, I love you. I love everybody, bro. And I just had to tell that a real quick hood story time, bro. Because all the time, I ain't got to tell y'all about some drama that's going on, bro. Sometime, I got to let you know a nigga was having fun, too, bro. Yeah. And y'all already know I had just got out anyway, so yeah, nigga, we're having some good old fun down there, bro, in that good old Texas, bro. Nigga didn't want to come back, so like I say before I end the story, I'm so drunk, I done finally realized it. Man, what the fuck DP done made with my car? Like, what the fuck? Now I'm coming to my two, like, I done let this nigga drive my car, him and Freddie of all goddamn people, and these niggas done, but lo and behold, guess what they pulled up? They pulled up with that wet daddy. Them nigga pulled up with that wet daddy. And they was tripping. Y'all already know they was tripping, bro. But like I say, man, that's another hood story time, bro. Rest in peace to my nigga Bradley. Rest in peace to Keisha. Rest in peace to my nigga DP, man. Free that nigga Fredo. Y'all already know. Shout out to everybody. I love y'all, man. That's Crispy Cliff, man. Another hood story time. Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe. Give me that algorithm, you heard me? Y'all are already doing what you do when you do, so I appreciate you for doing it. But we going to stay down until we come up together, man. It's your boy, Crispy Clean Cliff, man. I'm gone.
Man of the year, I'm the man of the... I'm pippin' like I'm Don Juan. I'ma stop at the store, sell me an onion. Go and get some backwoods in the back of Funyuns. Let a nigga play me sweetie, he gon' meet the honey bun. I ain't ride with it unless he got a 100-round drum. Hit that